Hi everyone, I am Shahan Laik. Welcome back to my channel. And in this video, I will be talking about a very, very important topic for NEET PG and DNB examination, that is Gilbert syndrome. So let us speak about it. So what happens in Gilbert syndrome? Basically, you can look the difference between the two men. So you can see how this man has been converted into this. What has happened? Yellowish of the skin. Can you see the skin? All these are yellowish colored. So there is excess amount of which pigment? Bilirubin. Excess amount of bilirubin in his body. So this is Gilbert syndrome. So why this bilirubin is increased in his body? Why this increase? Let us discuss about this. Now you can see this picture. Can you see the normal bilirubin metabolism? From where does bilirubin comes from? It comes from RBC. So from red blood cells you can get bilirubin, and that bilirubin need to be converted into its soluble form. So we need to convert bilirubin into its soluble form. Why do we need to be converting bilirubin in its soluble form? Because we need to excrete. We need to excrete bilirubin. Basically, we need to put it in the bile, and from there we can excrete the bilirubin. That is why we need to solubilize bilirubin. We need to make the bilirubin more soluble in water. And we can excrete it through bile. So that is the need of converting the bilirubin, unconjugated bilirubin, into conjugated bilirubin. So this process is known as conjugation. Conjugation means the process by which insoluble bilirubin is converted into soluble bilirubin is known as conjugation. The process by which insoluble bilirubin is converted into its soluble form is known as conjugation. So you can see in the picture here how this process is done. From bilirubin, it is converted into bilirubin glucuronide. So what is the meaning of this? Bilirubin is converted into bilirubin glucuronidase. So basically what happens, there is an enzyme which you can see in the liver, and this is UGT1A1. So what is this enzyme? UGT1A1 means UDP glucuronyl transferase. So this is the enzyme. So UDP glucuronyl transferase. So UGT. UGT1A1 is the enzyme that is needed for converting bilirubin into its soluble form. So you can understand we need this enzyme UGT1A1. UGT1A1 is the enzyme that we require to convert it into its soluble form, UDP glucuronyl transferase. UDP glucuronyl transferase is the enzyme. So let us go to the next slide, where I will be talking in details about this process. Now you can see here, first we have the senescent RBC. What is the meaning of the term senescent RBC? Senescent means old RBC. They are old now. So what happens? You have the hemoglobin which is released from this RBC. Now this hemoglobin, from that hemoglobin, we can break the hemoglobin into two parts. So HB is converted into heme and globin. So there are two parts of this, heme and globin. So from that part, we can actually convert the heme part. him part into believardin. You can see him part is converted into believardin. Now believardin will be converted into unconjugated bilirubin. So this believardin is converted into unconjugated bilirubin. From that unconjugated part, conjugated bilirubin is formed. That means soluble bilirubin is formed. So you can understand the process. Once again, let me describe it. That is, first the RBC is there, which is senescence RBC. From that RBC, we can get the hemoglobin. And from that hemoglobin, we get heme. That heme is converted into bilirubin. And bilirubin is converted into unconjugated form of bilirubin. And that unconjugated bilirubin will be converted into conjugated or soluble bilirubin. So this unconjugated bilirubin is converted into conjugated bilirubin. This insoluble bilirubin is converted into soluble bilirubin with the help of this enzyme UGT1A1. That is UDP glucuronyl transferase 1A1. UDP glucuronyl transferase 1A1. UDP glucuronyl transferase 1A1. UDP glucuronyl transferase 1A1. This is the enzyme. So that is required, UGT1A1. But in this patient, in Gilbert syndrome, this enzyme is decreased. UGT1A1 is decreased. UDP glucuronyl transferase 1A1 is decreased. So we get more amount of unconjugated bilirubin in the blood. So we get more amount of unconjugated bilirubin in the blood. So basically this is known as hyper unconjugated bilirubinemia. So what is the meaning of this? Hyper means more, unconjugated form, that is those forms which has not been solubilized, those form which is not conjugated. So hyper unconjugated bilirubinemia means increased amount of bilirubin in the blood. So that is hyperbilirubinemia, and which is unconjugated in form. You can understand why this is occurring due to lack or decrease in UGT1A1, due to decrease in the enzyme UDP glucuronyl transferase 1A1. Now why this name is glucuronyl transferase? Basically what happens, you have the unconjugated bilirubin, in that glucuronic acid is added. So you can understand, glucuronic acid is added to the unconjugated bilirubin to form conjugated bilirubin. Glucuronic acid. So what is the use of this glucuronic acid? Why this glucuronic acid is added? Glucuronic acid is added to the unconjugated bilirubin to convert into soluble bilirubin, to form the soluble, to increase the solubility, to make it conjugated, to make it more soluble. We add glucuronic acid, and this is done by the process of conjugation. Basically, you have this molecule UDP glucuronate. That means it is a molecule which contains glucuronic acid. UDP molecule which contains glucuronic acid. So this molecule, when it is leaving, you can see it is leaving as UDP. That means it has deposited the glucuronic acid to the unconjugated bilirubin. So UDP glucuronate converted into UDP. How? By delivering the glucuronic acid to the unconjugated bilirubin. So we can get conjugated bilirubin by that. So you can understand the full process, how it is done. Basically what happens, let me revise once again. You have the senescent RBC, from that we have hemoglobin, so we can take the heme. From the heme we can get bilirubin. Bilirubin converted into unconjugated bilirubin, and for converting the unconjugated bilirubin to conjugated bilirubin, we need glucuronic acid. Who will deposit this glucuronic acid? Who will deliver to glucuronic acid? Unconjugated bilirubin is very much sad. The unconjugated bilirubin is sad. Who will deposit? At that time we get UDP glucuronate. UDP glucuronate said, I am the hero, I will deposit to you. So glucuronic acid is deposited by UDP glucuronate to unconjugated bilirubin. Now our unconjugated bilirubin is happy and it is converted into soluble bilirubin. So you can understand this process of conjugation. For that we need an enzyme known as UGT1A1, UDP glucuronyl transferase 1A1. So if that enzyme is lacking, then this process is not done. So we will be having increased amount of unconjugated bilirubin in the blood. So the person will be suffering a kind of jaundice, and this is known as the Gilbert's syndrome. So you can see here the process of conjugation in details. So you have that bilirubin, and that bilirubin is converted into bilirubin monoglucuronide and then bilirubin diglucuronide. Mono means one, glucuronide means one glucuronic acid is added, di means two, glucuronide means glucuronic acid has been added. So bilirubin monoglucuronide when one glucuronic acid is added, and then it is converted into bilirubin diglucuronide when two glucuronic acid is added. And who is adding this glucuronic acid? He is actually UDP glucuronic acid. You can see here. Okay, this is the enzyme. This is actually the enzyme. So UDP glucuronyl transferase is the enzyme, and the fellow is UDP glucuronic acid. So after depositing the acid, it is converted into UDP. So UDP glucuronic acid converted into UDP by depositing the glucuronic acid, and the enzyme is UDP glucuronyl transferase. Hope it is clear to you. Both times it is the same thing that is happening. Now let us go to the next part, that is this symptom. You can see the sclera. So the sclera, the whitish portion of the eye, you can get the yellowish coloration. This is also the same thing, that is having the bilirubin increased in the body. So other features which you may have if you have Gilbert syndrome is fatigue. You may have fatigue, you may have loss of appetite, you may not feel like hungry. Another thing is abdominal pain. So you may have pain in the abdomen, cramping in the abdomen, abdominal pain, and you don't like to eat, you are fatigued, you have loss of energy. So all these are features of Gilbert syndrome. So this is the end of this video. If you like this video, make a thumbs up and subscribe this channel for getting many more medical videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, write a comment down below. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.